The government yesterday announced an extension of the partial credit guarantee scheme for NBFCs and housing finance companies. PSU banks can now purchase BBB plus rated assets against the earlier rule of buying assets rated AA. So how will this move impact housing finance companies? Let's ask Manish Jaiswal of Magma FinCorp, who is joining us right now on the show. Mr. Jaiswal, thanks very much for taking out the time and speaking with us. Obviously, this definitely is a positive that's come in, but to how big a help is this going to be?
Good morning for having me on the show. I must say this was much needed respite. I think we are 15 months into a full-blown NBFC crisis. While the earlier statements have been expressions of intent, very clearly this hasn't taken off. While some banks have given guarantees, but on-ground disbursements haven't really happened. So the two key issues which have been addressed, they are largely as to who will give the guarantee. That has come out clear, albeit late. And the second issue around SMA zero, I think that also is a ticklish smaller issue, but that has also been tackled well. So while these two problems will certainly open up the tap, but I still feel that there are a few more things which should be really thought through, because let's understand, a BBB plus pool will have to be probably notched by banks. They may not have the appetite. And once you notch up, the additional liquidity which you have to set aside, that might be expensive. This apart, you have to pay for pool rating expenses, and bankers will charge processing fee. They are charging, given the risk aversion, a higher price. So viability can get questioned. So therefore, linking this to closer to MCLR or making a pricing which is cost effective has to be really important.
Mr. Jaiswal, you know, the analyst community is also questioning whether or not this resolves the issue with regards to the divergence between credit supply to NBFC and the sustained aversion of wholesale lenders. So how do you think this is going to get tackled by this?
Let me confirm that this is not at all tackled. There has been a 135 basis point repo rate cut. And I can tell you that most NBFCs, including ours, have had 100 to 150 basis of points increase, which means the divergence is of 250 basis points. It led to a situation where profitability of most NBFCs is under question. I can clearly mentioned that the pre-crisis rates of also well-rated NBFCs and current, despite the rating being constant and asset quality largely staying in the range of 1,500 basis points, the cost of funds has sharply moved. It has come to a stage where, in fact, most NBFCs are sharply reprioritizing assets. I can confirm to you that in hinterland, the supply of financing for new commercial vehicles or new cars by NBFCs would have sharply declined, and that would also be affecting economy.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Jaiswal, just one question from my end. I think not for Magma FinCorp, but I'm just trying to think that if I'm a large lender, a PSU bank which has liquidity available, wants to lend but is not sure about whether about the safety of my loans, then even if these norms are relaxed, will I go out and lend to some of the NBFCs who need the money, but I'm not sure about their ability to pay back? Would that get changed as a result of this? Or that still remains, right?
You're very right. That's a great question. The first and single largest important thing for a housing finance company, what they worry about, this is a 20-year loan. What will happen after 2 years? So this is something which they might really say, that if this guarantee was for 3 to 4 years, at least the loan is a little more seasoned, they will have more appetite. I think one clear question they will have is around tenor. Second question is that most NBFCs have sectoral caps. Unless and until the sectoral caps of non-AAA rated NBFCs is not established, there will be a problem. Given current liquidity, the AAA rated NBFCs have actually taken a lot more of the available pool within the sectoral cap for NBFCs. So they will prioritize, there is a polarization. So obviously funds are moving in that direction. how do you address non-AAA rated NBFCs? That is also going to be important. I think these are two important criteria. And the third thing is that there is a limitation of 20% of outstanding loan at the end of last financial year. In my view, while the good thing is they've capped at 5,000 crore, but honestly, 20% could just about be 2 months of disbursal. If you look at a six-month horizon, at least the amount should cover at least last 6 months of disbursal so that at least there is quantum which is available. And for that, these banks, they need to be given that appetite to be able to fund the NBFCs.
Got that. Mr. Jaiswal, one final question. How does this, you know, personally impact Magma FinCorp? Is there any meaningful impact that you see for Magma FinCorp on the back of the scope being increased?
For Magma, we have sufficient liquidity. I would say we have been able to build up liquidity which will last us till March. The issue which we would like to really address is very clearly cost of fund. Given partial guarantee, which is almost like a sovereign cover for 2 years, and our loans, typically an average maturity of loans around 27 months, I think it is imperative to see that under PCG scheme, if the cost of fund can reduce our ability to cater to those segments which we've abandoned for last 6 or 7 months, can improve, and that can actually rev up the consumption of autos, cars, commercial vehicles in the hinterland.